myself here. I just okay. So I won't have it in terms of time. So I will just go ahead to a bit. I think that I just like to introduce that I actually we have just last year the cabinet has approved of this new energy center within NASA. So now I actually been working in MTech. You know, as we've seen, I've been for a long time, but now I'm just changing my hat or my coat to be just MTech for the energy technology center. So a lot of the information here actually coming from the fact that I also have been a founding committee of the Electric Vehicle Association of Thailand. I think I met, of course, Dr. Yun, Yuna many times. I think we many of the talk and also lecture around this interesting and exciting topic. So we in Thailand, we actually have this event establishment since 2015. We have been trying to actually promoting the electric vehicle usage in Thailand. And you can see that we have a lot of members, both the individual as well as the corporate. And I think we try to be a linkage between the academic, you know, and also the industry, both the SME in Thailand as well as the big corporation from abroad. So with our association, we just have kind of information and also maybe some of the things that we could try to gather, some of the characteristics and also the information not specifically to any company, but also I think to most of the sector in electric vehicle supply chain in Thailand. Just a bit before moving to EV itself and charging station infrastructure, just want to show you that I think this is a snapshot of the Thailand in the past, I think 20 years that we have been growing and government is putting a lot of promotion and also policy to support the automotive industry in Thailand. You can see that since the crisis of Tom Yum Kung back in 1997, so our auto industry has been, I think, climbing and supporting. You can see from 1998, 1999, up until I think we have a crisis here, rather Hamburger crisis. And the interesting thing to see that every time we have a crisis, the government is trying to boost up the production and for the utilization of the vehicle. And one thing I want to point out to you is that if you look at the two colors here, the base is a dark blue. This is actually the domestic sale. And also the lighter blue is actually for export. So you can see that Thailand, we have been promoting the auto industry for self-consumption until I think the year, we have almost 10 years ago that we actually have a sector of the exporting more than 50% of our production in Thailand. And of course, you know, I think like other country with the COVID-19, then our production has dropped. So this is the status of the electric vehicle in Thailand. I think you can see that actually this is, we have this information sharing on our association event website. You can check it for the regular update. So if you look at this chart, this is actually the accumulated electric vehicle registration in Thailand. If you look in the left-hand side here, we just date back about 4 or 5 years. So you can see that the number of accumulated has been increasing. And I think we just only a few years ago where actually the Department of Land Transport has already segregated the registration of the EV into HEV and PHEV. Previously, there is no differentiation between HEV and PHEV, but then after the year last year, then there are separate classification for registration in this DLT. The good thing about this is that what we as a researcher can do is actually we can estimate the additional loading coming from the grid when we have this, of course, electric vehicle growing in Thailand. If you look on the right-hand side here, of course, you can see that there's a various kind of the vehicle that has been electrified in Thailand. You can see we have this is a full EV, your battery electric vehicle. This is a plug-in hybrid. This is a HEV where we have no plug at all. You can see that if you look at the BEV here, we actually have a lot of motorcycle. I think this is more than 50%. And this is why we actually work in collaboration with UNEP on actually focusing on the two-wheeler, electric two-wheeler here. And if you look into the plug-in hybrid and also this hybrid vehicle, it actually is become the sedan. And you can see here, this sector for the BEV, actually, I think about 40% is actually been a growing diverse coming from the four-wheeler that's coming from China, because we have this free trade agreement where the import, electric vehicle import from China has no tax. And if you look at the new registration, so this is actually also increasing, you know, for the past 5 years. And since last year, we have a differentiation between the BEV, PHEV, and HEV here. So the trend is still the same. And if you look at the right-hand side in the pie chart here, you can see that I think the BEV is dominated by motorcycle, 50%, and then followed by the sedan here. So this is in both English and Thai letter here. This is also the similar figure, the figure for the PHEV actually dominated by the four-wheeler. This is because of the Department of Excise Tax has reduced the excise tax when the vehicle actually has some electrified unit or the plug-in hybrid in the case. Now, if you look into the charging infrastructure in Thailand, you can see on the left-hand side here, we have, I think right now, this is the information we have as of August. We have about, I think, 600 something charging vehicle infrastructure here. And you can see that there are also different operators that actually coming to play as a in terms of the service provider, ranging from a new faces and as well as some of the old faces like PTT, which is a national oil company, some of the electric vehicle, I mean, some of the electricity authority generation of Thailand, like next year here on this side, on the right hand side, yeah, this is the main electricity generator of Thailand, which is stated in the price. And sometimes we have this MEA, or PA, this is also the transmission of the electricity in Thailand as well. And this actually, we have also some SI electricity tariff, which actually cheaper than actually the electricity get used in the household, so that it could be something that to be incentive by the business for people who want to make an investment in this charging station business. And now I think also not only the electricity company or the oil company that switching into the electricity, but the bank itself also finding opportunity here. You can see this is Siam Commercial Bank, one of the big banks in China, actually has a package that allows some of the investor that could be able to destroy this also in Thai, but it just say that you can actually invest also for this package that could actually also get a return in 7 years. So, and I forgot to mention that if you look in the infographic on the left hand side here, so we have, I think, about 1,900 charging stations varying different between is your AC or the normal charge or DC, as you can see classified here. So besides that, I think last year, 2020, I think the government has been launching this, what we call the National Electric Vehicle Policy Committee, and actually headed by the Deputy Prime Minister. So I think our president from EVAT and also ASTAFTA has been a member of this big committee, and also there's a subcommittee, a working group. So there are actually four subcommittees that's trying to look at how Thailand could promote this electric vehicle industry. So we have, for example, we have a promotion and manufacturing of the EV, and we have the development of the infrastructure for the battery also. And we have the impact assessment, because I think Thailand as other country in ASEAN as well, that if we have a lot of EV, which means that of course, our fossil fuel will be used less, but our fossil fuel in Thailand are actually blend with biofuel. So for some ethanol and biodiesel, so we have to also be mindful that if we're promoting EV, of course it doesn't come like 100% now, but in the future, we must have some way for those industry that has been established earlier, especially in the biofuel, actually ethanol, where also the EV has been replacing the use of the gasoline. So we have to check with that. And last but not least, also looking at the supplement and promoting the EV usage in that. So this is actually the Thailand target that announced earlier this year. So we have, we call it ZEV, which is zero electric vehicle. So by definition, the zero electric vehicle is for BEV or fuel cell FCEV only, not including the HEV or PHEV. And these are actually the latest target that the government has been put forth in the news as from the meeting from the National Electric Vehicle Policy Committee. You can see that the target is actually to have the 100% of the electric vehicle usage by the year 2035. To me, this is also very challenging. And of course, I think government realize that and also trying to, I think, come up with many other package and also some policy to ease this achievement. And this electric vehicle measure also has been part of the implementation mechanism toward the Thailand carbon neutrality that has been announced last week as well in UK. So in the end, you can see that we can separate into the usage of the electric vehicle and also the production of electric vehicle. As I showed earlier, that Thailand, we actually producing more than what we use in the country. So we are mainly targeting the production for export as well. And we can also target for the passenger vehicle, motorcycle, bus, which is a three-wheeler or the trike like in the Philippines, and also ship and also the rail. So this is some of the target that has been, I think, circulated around the media. Now, if you focus more on the cars and pickup. Pickup is basically the light duty vehicle in Thailand, which is very popular. So these are some of the intermediate target like 2022, 2025, 2030, and 2035. So this is just one of the things that you can see that right now the government actually using focusing on this target 2030 to have a 30% production of the vehicle in Thailand to be zero emission vehicle in Thailand. So in other words, we must reach about the 7 to 5 million electric vehicle production in Thailand in the next, I guess, 6 years. We'll see if we can achieve that. And also, I think not only the electric vehicle itself as a target, but the government also launched this target for infrastructure as well as a charging station. So you can see that on the top here, which is accumulated pickup truck, and this is the charting for, you know, for DC quick charge and also for the normal DC to respond to the car target on the left figure, on the left column. And also for the electric motorcycle, I think we have accumulated the target here, as you can see, and also the charger for the target. And I think I will also touch upon the fact that not only the charging vehicle, a charging station for electric two-wheeler, but also the battery swapping is also starting to appear, I think, as a summer demonstration project in Thailand. And just recently, last month, and we have this said that it has been launched approved in Thailand. So here in the next 4 or 5 slides, I just want to show you some of the, I think, demonstration that has been you can see in the news regarding the focusing on the electric two-wheeler. I think here this is about 2 years ago. This is coming from the one of the university, Thammasat University, which is actually near my office. And also with the company Star 8, they have been launching this, I think, the electric two-wheeler project within the university campus. So they are actually trying to enhance the fact that they can use the sustainable transportation within the university. And also there are some of the swapping option that has been tried in the university as well. Another one is actually coming from Thailand Post. I think this is similar to, I think, the Deutsche Post in Germany, that they are trying to moving or replacing the fossil fuel vehicle by the electric vehicle. So in this case, Thailand Post also doing this project covering the truck, also the four-wheeler and also the electric two-wheeler here. So they actually, because working with the bamboo industry, which also a Thai company that has been investing in the coal mine industry. So you can see that even the coal company, they are now also trying to diversify their portfolio, moving away from the conventional energy to the electric vehicle or the battery in the future. Another one for DHL in Thailand. I think DHL is similar to Thailand Post. They're also having this project that launching this usage of the electric two-wheeler and also using this as a vehicle to to deploy the package throughout the customer. So here they're also trying to use this 50 electric motorcycle for delivery, and also they are trying to have this I think the charging and swapping session here at the depot itself. And here, this is also another project called Winnoni, and actually this is just being playing by the word Win in Thailand. This means that the rider that actually serving electric two-wheeler taxi, and me in Thailand mean, yeah. So basically that the Winnoni in Thai would mean that the rider or the motorcycle taxi without them. So this is a project actually launched by Bangcha, which is another oil company in Thailand. They are trying to, I think, also diversify their portfolio from just only fossil fuel refinery into the electric motorcycle. And also they have this electric project that working with the taxi rider in Bangkok here. So this is actually one of our previous Minister of Higher Education. They also invited to be part of this the project on the launching last year. Also, this is another one coming from the EGAT, which is the Electricity Generating Authority of Thailand. So Thailand, we still have this not a free market or the trading internet electricity. We still have the enhanced single buyer. So we only have one big producer in Thailand, which is State Enterprise, which is EGAT. And this EGAT, here also, they are focusing on various types of vehicle, ranging from the motorcycle here, and also the boat. And also this is, has been some of the diversified portfolio from EGAT that's trying to actually move away from the fact that if in the future there are people using less and less electricity regarding from the off-grid and also from the self-consumption from prosumer, then the EGAT would find the business. And in this case, they are also doing their project on electrifying transportation. And also they also help in terms of the PM2.5 pollution that we see in Bangkok as well. Now, the last topic that I want to touch upon is actually some of the work that I've been I've been collaborating with the UNEP. And this is actually working with the TC. Also, TC stands for the Thailand Industrial Standard Institute. For TC, they actually, their job is to launch the vehicle that, I mean, not the vehicle, but the standard for various things, including the vehicle and also the electric vehicle. So you can see that by TC, there are two standard type. So they also the voluntary and the mandatory. So for those, I think the industrial food application that may be concerned of the safety for the public, then the TC require a mandatory certification. But for example, for electric vehicle, especially the one that we just, they have been launching recently, is still under the voluntary basis because they are not sure yet whether how the market will accept this standardization or requirement. So with this, so we have this workshop earlier this year. Actually, it's a hybrid workshop because of the COVID. Then we also have been lucky to have some of the also presenter from TC as well as from UNEP. And for this one, TC has been, I think, back since earlier this year, launching the subcommittee to work toward the standard, the national standard on battery swapping. So basically they are focusing on the dimension, the voltage, the connector, and also the safety as a beginning of this standardization. And previously from last year, this is has shown that we have, the TC has been, I think, look at the international standard, for example, from ISO. So in this case that we actually translate and also minor slight modification of some of the content that to be suitable for the local environment. So for this TISI 3105, which is actually dealing for the performance of the moped and motorcycle, there has been looking at, I think, two parts. The part one is also similar to the ISO 13064. On the reference energy consumption and range, as well as the road operating and characteristics. So this has been, I think, announced as a national standard already last year. And this year, they just, I think just last month, we just have approval from the board of the TC. that now we have this new standard that called the electric moped and motorcycle, especially on the removable rechargeable electric energy storage system. So as I shown in the previous two slides, we are focused on the dimension here and also looking at the connectivity connector as well as the safety for this swapping battery scheme in Thailand. And this is my concluding remark. I think for in terms of the case study or less screen sharing from Thailand, I think Thailand is like after the open country that we also see that the infiltration of this electric vehicle is coming to the country is, I think, unstoppable. But now what we should do is how can we adapt or how can we prepare for this disruptive technology that could actually change the lifestyle of people and also perhaps, I think, bring the quality of the life for the people who live in the city. And for me, I think personally, I think EV and also charging station is a chicken and egg. So who want to invest what first? But they have to go together between chicken and egg or the EV and also charging station. And the fact that I think we heard earlier in the speaker that battery swapping, I think especially for the electric two-wheeler, you know, could help in kind of speeding up of the deployment of the electric two-wheeler. I think we've seen Google in Taiwan that although there are no national standards, but I think the people will use it so widespread so that it becomes the industrial standard. I think government support also for both physical and non-physical mechanism can help, I think, in terms of this infrastructure deployment and also starting to kick off. And last but not least, I think with the political meeting last week in Glasgow COP26, I think has been a good, I think, not excuse, but a good opportunity for us to actually drive forward with the technology that could actually, you know, clean the air for our shooting in the future and also trying to reach the carbon neutrality. So with that, I would end my presentation here. So, and